making sculpture reach areas beyond our own physical height is just an adventure. The way I begin is often through dimensions, the actual size of the building, and using those dimensions as a starting point.
I like to think of the first work that you encounter when you walk into the exhibition, 100 Banners, as a leitmotif for the entire show. There are three protagonists with every work, with every sculptural encounter: the object itself, the space, and the public. And through the idea that there is no ideal viewing angle in order to see the work in its entirety, it compels the viewer to move. We have two works here that are exhibited for the first time and really respond to the dimensions of this main gallery space. This work is called Untitled Rubble Catcher, and was actually realized quite literally on site here during the installation. And the other work is called Untitled Tower Holder, and this is probably one of the tallest she's ever done.
I like the processes of looking up beyond the eye level. Drawing is something I do the whole time. I always have a sketchbook with me. I like to be able to put things into the sketchbook, even if they're seemingly just a mindless scribble. And these ones are, in a way, that next stage where I'm actually planning the sculptures. Almost like an image of a sculpture, their information. A lot of the drawing is based on observation, but it's not based on accuracy, it's based on the opposite. It's based on what gets retained through memory. Those are the things I'm interested in. Whatever the work reminds you of is not what the work is. Something might look like a column, but it isn't a column. And it can't possibly function as a column. It's like a phantom version of something that it might remind you of.
There are several works here where an element appears to be on the verge of collapse. We see balconies without bodies on top of them. We see awnings that are providing no cover. We see umbrellas, for example, that remain closed and propped against the wall. And by removing the use value from these objects, Barlow compels the viewer to actually focus on their form.
I like the idea of the visual arts being a place where logic can be argued with and we can be irrational. Yes, so these shapes here are began life as this drawing here. But between the drawings and these sculptures, I made the models. So with complicated technical works like these, there are various stages that the objects go through, from these very scruffy diagrams to a model, and then eventually the final thing. The plan for the exhibition was to try and select examples of the kind of themes I've used over the last, say, 20 to 30 years.
The artist used the opportunity to actually recreate what is probably her most famous work. It's called Shed Mesh.
That was quite a trial, remaking something from 1975, you know. But where that can go, if it's not just about copying a specific work, but revisiting the process of that, I found really interesting. A lot of the works are adapted to the space they are in. And that, of course, is always exciting, that a work can take on a new character.
We wanted to use the building itself. You can deliberately look across the spaces. You can look from one gallery through another into another.
There are rooms where you're looking at one work and then you turn to look at another and there's a relationship builds up.
A lot of the works here encourage the viewer to wander through them, wander around them, and always renegotiating that relationship between themselves, the space, and the object.
I'm interested in how sculpture explores space and cuts into space. The space is a kind of solid material that I have to plow into in some way, and in a way hope that I can lead an audience into that as well.